Hey good people, how's it going? Welcome to Trapped in the South. Today's video is a day in the life of JMN. Today is a super busy day. We actually got up pretty early and we headed to Arkansas to go get windows for the gray house. First thing we did was stop at McDonald's to get some breakfast for everybody, and they had these cute little paper bags. Then we drove about an hour and a half to this Home Depot to get these 32 by 39 windows that I needed for the gray house. While we were out, we realized that FedEx came to deliver a package, but if you look closely, you can see that they didn't really deliver it where they were supposed to. They just left it in the middle of our driveway because they were afraid of our dogs. So after we got home, we put the kids down after they had lunch, and I came outside to find JMN. It looks like he's welding a part of his trailer to better fit this thing that like holds the trailer down in place. Looks like he was like burning a hole so he could fit or screw that thing in better than what it was. So I had to wait a little bit for him to get done working on that. That is actually his family's trailer that they've had for quite a long time, and then it's the family tractor, so that he just got back from the shop, so I'm sure he'll be hauling things around the house. So after that, we went and picked up our nephew, and we headed to the Home Depot in our town. We picked up some wood, there's my nephew right there, and then we stopped by the gray house. Look at those windows, sneak peek! Then we headed to another little small city to work on another house that we are trying to get together. You might see them there taking some appliances that we have had in storage. At this point, we are moving one thing from one place and vice versa. Once we start working on something, then we move it to the next location, and then back and forth. These appliances are actually from our first house that we bought in 2012, and after a couple years, we updated the appliances, and they were still really good appliances, so we wanted to hold on to them because you never know when you might need something. So here, we needed to get this wood out of the yard so that we can mow the yard and take better care and tend to the land. Actually, a couple weeks ago, we came in, JMN cut the wood. I'm not sure if that video is going to go up before or after this video, but I got some pretty decent footage of us doing that. This is actually our third load or third time coming, trying to fill the trailers up with wood, or just, I guess I should say, taking care of this part of the land. I don't know what type of tree that once was there, but I mean, it produced a lot of wood, as you can see. JMN is in the back rolling up some of that, and you can see me and my nephew. This house previously had some work done on it, and I think instead of just taking all of the boards and things that came off of the house that was being repaired, they just kind of like threw it in this little junk pile. Well, this little junk pile had, I mean, just about everything in it. I mean, there was a painting tarp and lots of trim and insulation, and of course that trim had nails in it. You'll see later on in the video, I'm out here in my Crocs and wasn't paying attention and stepped on one of these nails, and I cannot explain to you the pain that it caused. Here's my handsome other half dragging a big old log up on the trailer. It was a beautiful day. It was kind of warm that day, like the wind was blowing, but it was still kind of warm at the same time. But it was a perfect day to be outside working. We were so thankful that our nephew needed something to do and we could put him to work. So the structure that you're looking at right now is actually another shop. My husband's father built this. Well, I'm sure they probably built it together. And it's pretty large. I think it has two bays on it. And this blue greenish thing that you're looking at is the back of a truck bed that was made into a trailer. I'm really hoping that once we are done picking up all this brush, that that does not come home with me or anywhere near me. You see that was paneling? That's paneling also that I just lifted up. We're very thankful that there were not any unwanted critters in this pile. Winter is wrapping up, and you never know when you are lifting up things, what's under it, what's around it. There's a lot of grass in this area, so this stuff has probably been, like, I know it's not probably, over a year. And so you never know what has made its home around it. Oh, look, I'm about to do it. I wish I could get a countdown in 5. 4, 3, 2, 1. See, oh. Check out that ankle work, though. I don't even think I cussed. That's the best thing about it. I was a G about it. Look, I still was trying to make sure that it got back. It got on the trailer. Yeah. My husband's always telling me about doing yard work in unapproved yard work shoes. And I mean, the fact that I have Crocs on is honestly an upgrade for me, because normally I would be out there in $2 Old Navy flip flops getting things done. But the yellow Crocs, man, they failed me. So you see him here locking up the shop. This trailer full of wood actually had this 03 Silverado, I want to say, squatting in the back. I mean, I should have taken a picture of the tires, but I didn't. So like I said, this is our third load. We probably have another load and a half left just to get all this other brush up. Because right now, even if I took a lawnmower to where we were, sticks are going to be flying. Like, little fine sticks are going to be flying everywhere. My camera was doing, every time that they would throw a piece of wood, my camera would just move left, right, up, back, and there I am readjusting it, trying to get it back on track. Look how handsome he is. He just gave me a high five. It's crazy with an hour of your time, what you can really get accomplished. I know during the pandemic, there's been a lot of deep couch sitting, and you forget, like, honestly, you forget how it feels to get up and get in the sun and go do things. And I've always been an outsidesy person, so, like, this does not bother me whatsoever. I know it looks like we're about to wrap up soon. This guy looks pooped. I don't even remember what we were talking about here, but probably something ridiculous, as per usual. So after we left here, we went back to the house to unload the truck and burn wood. Of course, there was a minor hiccup when burning the wood, just trying to be safe conscious and having water hose available just in case the wind picks up and leaves catch fire. Unfortunately, our post was broken and JMN had to do some nursing around on it in order for us to have water that night. Oh, that's me just kind of panning around and showing you, hey, look what we've gotten done. Be proud of our progress. And here's a trailer full of wood in the back of the truck that is definitely squatting. And there I am. And we are off. That's the wood burning. Nice little bonfire. It's cute. And here he is after working on getting stuff done. So, thank you guys for watching.